Welcome to Young Business Professionals. I hope you're fine. I'm Felix and today I'm going to release another video for young business professionals in English. I will explain to you in about 10 minutes the most important facts to be considered in APQP Phase 0. If you are interested in increasing your automotive knowledge, please feel free to subscribe to my channel and like the video. You may also check out our Facebook page through which we would like to create a community that shall support each other, growing everybody's knowledge. You may find the link below the video. What is the purpose of the very first APQP phase, the so-called phase 0 or RFQ phase? It is basically the one and only phase of the project that is typically not managed by the project manager, but by the corresponding sales team member, the so-called account or key account manager. The project manager is acting as a team member in this phase and typically just supporting. The whole process team is already on board and the target of that phase is to win the project from the customer in order to launch phase 1 afterwards. The RFQ phase might be divided into the following steps. Qualification of RFQ and kickoff, product specification and customer requirement analysis, conception, a drafted time plan creation, product cost calculation, budgeting and preliminary quotation, and of course also a final time plan creation, calculation and budgeting, a quality gate phase 0 and the approval of the required business case, and finally a final quotation and project nomination. Let's take a deeper look on each of these working packages on the following slides. Qualification of RFQ and kickoff. The description RFQ qualification is basically self-explaining. The target of this process step is to identify if it is worth to spend efforts on the received RFQ. Eventually, the handling of each RFQ costs a lot of resources, and resources means always money, which potentially might be lost in case the RFQ is lost. Typically, the supplier is performing a lot of efforts to win a project, so it is worth to really evaluate if working on that makes sense at all. It is useful to check if the RFQ is part of the business scope of the company. Is there a reasonable chance to win the project, making reasonable profit and sales volume? Pretty often, companies are losing strategic focus and should ask themselves if this specific RFQ is really in line with the strategy of the company. It makes sense to estimate roughly if the product can be quoted on competitive pricing, achieving a sustainable profit later on. Is the sales area of the company able to answer yes to all these questions, it should double check if all required information are available in order to provide them to the team. That will then run through a standardized analysis process. The following information should be available, and in case not, it should be responsibility of the sales team to collect them as soon as possible from the customer. Product requirements, including specification sheets, preliminary drawings or engineering standards. 3D files or a design space should be available. A time plan expectation by the customer or timing expectation by the customer should be expressed, including important milestones such as design freeze, first off tool parts or PPAP samples. The production volume and the production capacity that shall be realized must be clear. If all these information are available, it is time to introduce the RFQ to the whole project team. Therefore, it's useful to perform an RFQ kickoff meeting. The scope of the RFQ will be presented and rough design ideas might be discussed. Typically, teams raise some open points that can be either answered by the salesman or requested by the customer later. After this kickoff meeting, the team starts to work on a design concept and is identifying the feasibility and costs in a standardized process that will be described on the following slides. Product specification and customer requirement analysis. At the beginning of each RFQ phase, it is useful to create an overview about all customer requirements. This is of special importance, as this is a common fact that requirements won't be analyzed in the right way or won't be recognized at all. If the design of the product is not considering them, this might cause mistrust but also cost issues later on. In many cases, customers are providing specification sheets with more than 200 pages, and it typically takes a lot of effort to analyze them in detail. It is wise to include all functional areas in order to divide the effort in between all parties, but also in order to make sure technical requirements are understood in the right way. It is recommended to get in touch during that phase with the corresponding technical context of the customer, so engineering of supplier and engineering of customer may align themselves on the requirements and specification. It makes sense to summarize that analysis in a PowerPoint presentation or Excel sheet in order to use this information later during the RFQ phase. It makes sense to highlight requirements that can't be fulfilled or that have to be blocked, as these should be added to the quote later on. Conception. Once all requirements are understood, the team can start to work on a first design concept. 3D files are created that are not yet showing all technical details but are enough to identify product cost roughly. In addition, a bill of material, including material selection according to the customer specification, is useful. Based on the bill of material, the whole assembly process is drafted in a superficial manner, in order to estimate cycle times and investments in order to industrialize the product. Moreover, purchased components will be prepared to RFQ them preliminary at sub-suppliers, and also preliminary validation scope is defined based on the identified product requirements. Drafted time plan, product cost calculation, budgeting, and a preliminary quotation. Now it's time for the project manager to define a rough time plan for the project that includes the industrialization of all tools, equipments, and supplied components. Based on the superficial process flow of the assembly process, expected costs for the serial production of the product will be calculated. The full budget for the project will be defined that may include positions such as tools for prototypes and serial equipment, production equipment, staff which is involved in the project, hours per functional area, for instance, the project managing efforts, the engineering efforts, the efforts for process development, and similar. Cost for validation and testing might be included, as well as test equipment and gauges, as well as efforts for PPAP sampling. All these facts will be summarized in a preliminary quotation that can be shared already with the customer at this stage. Final time plan calculation and budgeting. The process of a RFQ is often taking several weeks or months. Pretty often customers is still implementing new requirements that need to be reflected and evaluated by the team. All that leads to several loops of the processes described before. Finally, this is resulting in a final quotation in which all information will be summarized and provided to the customer. In the final quotation, the following information should not be missing or are very important. It should give a special focus on correct information. The pricing and the delivery conditions must be clear. The tool lifetime should be mentioned, as well as the exit capacity date in the average per week or per week should be mentioned. It should be also pretty clearly said which requirements can be fulfilled and which not. Quality gate phase 0 and or approval of business case. In case the RFQ requires high investment or is of significant importance for the organization, the business case is often presented to the top management before sharing the final quote with the customer. If investments need to be taken, the account manager is presenting a return on investment calculation and explaining his assumptions for the business case. This might be realized in a so-called quality gate release process that can be counted as an approval of a quotation in case the company is organizing that procedure in that way. Final quotation and nomination. The released quotation might be provided to the customer then. Of course, several negotiation loops may come up before the customer is finally nominating the supplier. What are other important facts that should be considered in phase zero? In my opinion, it is important to really perform an RFQ qualification procedure. RFQs might be denied as well. Never forget that. That is helping the whole organization to focus on real essential RFQs, so available resources can be focused on really important requests for quotation. In addition, it is important to analyze and understand requirements, as misunderstanding may lead to bad surprises in the future. And it is also very important for all parties, customer and supplier, to be brave enough to discuss and reject unrealistic requirements in case they are. On the other hand, you should also think business-oriented, and sometimes it requires a bit of teamwork to fulfill challenging requirements. That's all from my side with regard to APQP Phase 0. Thanks to all of you for watching this video until the end. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm looking forward for your likes and for your feedback below the video. Please subscribe to my channel to not miss further APQP videos. Please feel free to join our Facebook community. You will find the link below the video. Have a great day.